Good morning, student. This is the fourth lecture for the computation of area, Simpson rule. And this is the last method of computing the area of irregular boundaries. And this is a special method for calculating the area having curved boundary. So, this method we are calculating in different way as comparison to other three methods, that is mean ordinate, average ordinate and trapezoidal rule. So let us discuss. In this rule, the boundaries between the end of ordinates are assumed to form an arc of the parabola. So here we are assuming you can see in the figure that we took two ordinates here, that A, C, F, D and F are one ordinates, and D, G, H, J and F are other ordinates. So this Simpson rule is also sometimes called parabolic rule. So the area between line AC and the curved DHF, so you can see in the figure that line AC and the curve DHF is equal, this area is equal to the sum of the area of trapezoid, that is ADFC and the area of segment, that is DHFE. DHFA. So two trapezoid we took here, that the area of line AC and the curve DHF is equal to the ADFC and DHF, right? We will discuss in detail this formula. So here we have divided into ordinates. So let O1, ordinates 1, 2 and 3 be the three consecutive ordinates at a regular interval. So here we have divided this figure as a three ordinate, the A, D, F, C as three ordinates, A, D as ordinates O1, E, B, B, E is ordinate 2 and CF as ordinate 3. So we can calculate the area. So area of trapezoid ADFC, that is first trapezoid, we can calculate by using the trapezoidal rule. We are knowing that area 1, that is first ordinate, last ordinate by 2 into twice of ordinates, by twice of distance, common interval. That is here you can see in the figure. That is this ADFC we are talking. So here common distance is D, twice of D here. This is nothing but twice of D. So what they have done, first ordinate plus last ordinates by 2 average into twice of D. So we can calculate the area of this ADFC. Okay. Now second area of segment, that is DHFA. So second area here, DHFE will be nothing but we have to calculate the area of the parabola. So here 2 by 3 into area of the closing parallelogram, that is GJFD, that is GJFD, this parallelogram area. So this is 2 by 3, we know the twice of common interval D. And HE is the ordinates here. You can see here, this is HE is the ordinate. So while calculating this DHFE, we will know the area of the second, that is A2 equal to twice of 3 area of enclosing GJFD. So twice of 3, twice 2D, as same here, into ordinates. Okay, so we have divided this all area into 9 ordinates, and we have named them as first, then even, odd, as the name 1, first, second even, third odd, then 4 even, 5 odd, 6 even, 7 odd, and 8 even, and last is odd. Okay, not odd but last means first and last, and then even odd, even odd. We have divided the ordinates like this, is divided into common ordinates, common interval D. So whole, as a whole, we can calculate the area, that is twice 2 by 3 into twice D common interval, as O2 minus first plus last by 2. You are understanding here what happened? See here. This is common here, 2 by 3 twice of T. Then mid ordinates here, this is mid ordinates O2. Minus first and last ordinates by 2. You are understanding the fact that, let us discuss this figure. What we are doing here, that O2 minus average of this 2. So we can determine the area of this. So total area will be twice 2 by 3 twice of D O2, that is mid ordinate, minus first plus last by 2, average of first and last, right? So this we have calculated, that is twice D by 3, 2 you can take as under. So twice ordinates 2 minus this 2 will be cancelled. So O first ordinate plus last ordinate. So total area we can get as area 1 plus area 2. You are knowing this, we have divided into 2 area, this things we have divided into 2 area, that this is nothing but area 1 and this is area 2. So we will get as this, as area 1 we are having this here, area 1 trapezoidal, this ADFC. So area 1 first ordinate plus last ordinate by 2 into twice of D. Okay, and area 2 we have calculated here, that is twice D by 3 and twice of O2 minus O1 minus O3. So this we will calculate here. So this will become, if we will sum this like this, if we will sum O1 plus O3 by 2 into twice of D plus twice D by 3 twice O2 minus O1 plus O3, right? So this will become common as D by 3, thrice of first ordinate plus thrice of last ordinate plus 4 of second ordinate minus first ordinate, twice of first ordinate minus twice of third ordinate. If we will calculate the A1 plus A2, so your total area will be D by 3, O1 plus 4 of O2 plus O3. So this is by calculating A1, this formula came while calculating A1 plus A2. Okay, So applying the above rule, two tract having 8 segments and 9 ordinates. So this rule, like this common formula we have derived, okay? So this rule in general, if we are having 9 ordinates and 8 segments, this rule we can use for this tract. You are getting this? For this tract, we are having 9 number of ordinates and this 8 interval. 8 segments, you can see. So you are here applying this above rule. So total area will become like d by 3 o 1 plus 4 o 2 o 3 as we have derived here, right? Plus, as you can see that o 1 is first ordinate and o 3 is the last ordinate, and twice of four times of o 2. So here you can derive here as o 3 first ordinate, o 5 last ordinate, plus 4 times of o 4 mid ordinates. Same here, o 5 first, this is o 7 last, and 4 times of o 6 mid ordinates. And same, o 7 first, o 9 last, and 4 times of mid ordinates. So total, if we can calculate sum of all this, then total area d by 3, o 1 plus o 9 means this will be the first ordinate and this is last ordinate, plus 4 times of, you can see here, o 2, o 4, o 6, o 8 means the even one number, 4 times of o 2, o 4, o 6, o 8. Plus twice of, you can see here that O3 here, again O3 here, then O5 here, again O5 here, O7 here, again O7 here. So it will become twice of O3, O5, O7. Understood? So in general, for n segments, you can say a total area equal to d by 3, first ordinates plus last ordinates plus 4 times the sum of even ordinates plus 2 times the sum of odd ordinates. So in common way, you can write that total area equal to common distance by 3, first ordinate plus last ordinates plus 4 times the sum of even ordinates plus 2 times the sum of remaining odd ordinates. Understood? So this is the final formula for the Simpson rule. So this rule is applicable only when number of division is even, that is number of ordinates is odd. So division is even, so number of division, if you have put 4, is okay, 6 is okay, then number of ordinates will become odd, like O1, O2, O3, O4, O5. So if the division 1, 2, 3, sorry, you can put here. See here division 1, 2, 3, 4, number of division. The 5 ordinates will come here. So this rule is applicable O1 as O2, O3, O4, O5. So this rule is applicable only when number of division is even and number of ordinates is odd. So here we have completed the Simpson rule. Hope you understand.